you wake up and score a point today? I know that I did not. Topic inspired by Wes Watson. I think it was the video that was posted today. I'm sure, because I looked at his videos based more off of title. But he brought up the point that when he wakes up at 2 in the morning, he says, and by me waking up early, that he's able to give himself 1 point. And then at the end of the day, he could say, yeah, I've got 35 points, 40 points, and it's a win. And me right now, I'll say that I didn't score that 1 point. And also my handicap, and I'll admit it, me being a nasty, weak snowflake, my caffeine has it's dwindled down. It's not, I can't hit the mouse right now. And that's me. That's just me not being as intense as physically possible. No excuses. I'm telling you that I'm not here saying, oh my goodness, carpe diem, seize the day, and fucking, you can do it, I can do it, let's make it happen. No, I like wearing pink fuzzy bunny slippers, sipping on my, what is that shit called? That hot mocha Starbucks drink, I don't know, or whatever their chocolatiest, tastiest, see this one, warmest, just the right temperature, yeah, that one. And I'm in charge of my mind, yeah. But lately, yeah, I've been letting other people say, hey, you know what? I'll take some of that tacit approval. Now, you know that I've gone into hell when I've said, oh my goodness, I don't have enough for Christmas presents. Oh my God. Life's not fair. Give me a dollar. It's not a GoFundMe. Give me about $350. Where's the people when they pull out money? Good money. Thousands, 10,000 or more. Stacks and stacks of thousands. I can say, hey, let me borrow 50 cents. I don't say give me, I'll say borrow. But I always say that in research purposes only. See how they react. Alright. Yeah, but I had to point that out. Again, me, I'm dropping the ball. Let me just make that note for the record on here. Work on this. So shape that. That's why. Too much. Thank you. Probably one of the things that I let defeat me today. It was a different trash can this morning. I guess it's some motherfucker just going through everyone's trash can and looking for recyclables. Usually the one that shakes me up. And that where that dumpster's at, it's not even like real close to where I'm at. That's a, since it's quiet in the morning. Fuck, there's an asshole. there's an asshole garbage truck driver who gets this one dumpster. And just the way that it's set up, I'm guessing you can go in there and pull it up and release this dumpster into its bin or whatever that's called, the back of it. Like, that shit loud as fuck. I mean, and it's I don't even know how early that is. Was it 5:30 in the morning? And I'm talking about fucking when he lets the fucking lifts it up, then shakes it. So he lifts this little dumpster, then shakes it, and then he slams it back down. I'm pretty sure you could I'm no garbage truck driver, but I'm guessing you probably could tilt it back. But then just put it forward. I don't know about. Anyways, how am I talking about that for? Yeah, so when I heard that fucking some motherfucker going through trash cans, slamming the lid, there's that fuck. Which when I woke up, because I always check if it's also if it's burglars. Because you hear all sorts of shit in the city. Wait, I'm thinking about this blue radio. How should I do that? A little bit darker than that one. You know, I was thinking, you know what? That's the city, just, that's the city rooster. Telling me, hey, wake up. Or it's even telling me, hey, ha 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 ha, you're gonna live on. I'm trying to think what are some of the biggest properties here. I don't think it's Beverly Hills. Where's the biggest property? It's Beverly Hills. Brentwood, San Marino, Palos Verdes. I don't know, but the way that I interpreted it was, life was telling me, hey, you don't have your 1 acre on each side with a brick wall to absorb some of the sound and double-plated bulletproof glass that keeping you safe and sound from the noises of the poor. The poor according to American standards, not the poor according to global standards, because global standards, I'm fucking shit, I probably have enough money to eat just in my wallet right now to eat groceries for a whole year in some countries. So no, I'm just thinking about that. Being spoiled, being effective, being comfortable, and really pushing. And I also think, well, you can't push too hard because get you super cold. Yeah, that's the city telling me, hey, you broke motherfucker. Fucking go make some real money. And go live somewhere else. Then I'll start thinking, fuck, last night, this morning. Watching the news. And, what didn't get to me was that there was an armed robbery on a couple. That didn't get to me. Or that it happened in Calabasas. What got to me is that that made the news. Where I'm at, there's a place where I frequent a lot, do business at. I'll tell you, probably within 150 yards, even closer, probably 100. Walk this way, shooting. Walk this way, murder. Walk this way, rape. Walk this way, discovered body. Walk this way, armed robbery. I'm talking about from the location where I'm at. Twice towards that location. I'm guessing someone tried to rob me or assault me, and then let it get that far. And again, criminals have rights here in California. Well, you see, he was just playing. He just had a mental disorder. He was under a lot of stress. I'm gonna fucking kill you, rip your fucking heart out, motherfucker, right now. With a fucking knife in your hand? No. But some people see it that way. Tell me about that chick. Oh, that chick had a booty. Story, take care of it. God damn. Such a smile. You think I'll pencil that micron that in? Yeah, that fucks with me mentally. Thinking, yeah, you know what? Homeless man, crazy motherfucker, bomb, garbage man, motherfucker. I just need to get away. And some people say, no, well, you just go back to sleep. And I'm thinking, it's an amazing time to some cops. Like, again, I lost count. If I called the cops, I think, 23 times this year, I believe. And at someone, hey, defund the police. I'm like, hey, defund them, fuck them. I need a vacation. This is going to protect your community. Your politicians. Fuck no. Fuck no. Yeah, am I winning against life? Am I? It's a game. It is a game. And you gotta just see. You know, one thing with situational awareness to see what's going on around you. I think at times for me, I start seeing behavior that's like, oh, well, you know what? I start looking around and I think, sometimes people say, well, you know, I don't go around looking and judge. I'm like, yes, you do. Yes, you do. You could go, you could see a little girl, a little boy, and say, you know what? That's not a threat. They're quiet. They're not going to get in the way of my job, my shopping, my lunch, my latte. This motherfucker over here is distracted. Better look out the way. He's a dumb motherfucker. But with having situational awareness, man, I've seen some people that are like, I think, damn, are. There's no wars, no plague, no conflict. Somehow you've survived all this and you're here next to me, enjoying this. This latte, this voting privilege, this television, this living room, this business, this chance to stand in the DMV and wait for the fucking get your car registered. Oh, you see, you're a psychopath and you didn't do anything. Mm-mm-mm. Her boogies thinking, doing. Someone I haven't seen in a while. thinking about so when that trash can tells me to, garbage man tells me, people, the homeless people tell me, hey, fuck everything, fuck everybody, slam this trash can here. I'm a litter shit, throw shit, trash all over the fucking place. And you know, those are things that I can't control. But you know, isn't it pathetic? On everyone's end, even me, that I live amongst such a civilization where, you know, there are times where I'll go out on a dog, on a dog walk, some water, and I see, if you saw me walking down the street, you probably think, oh, God, what's wrong with that guy? Is he depressed? What's wrong with him? Because I have my head down. But I'm familiar with sunspots on my dog walk. So it's some fucking idiot here leaves fucking shit. And I have to look. There's still this one motherfucker that haven't caught him, who walks their dog on the sidewalk and lets them shit on the sidewalk. He doesn't even let them shit sometimes, because I see that the shit marks that are, you tell that he's probably walking and shitting. You're fucking this dog shit in peace, man. He did it to one address, to an apartment building, where he did it on their walkway. I'm not thinking, you motherfucker. Kick your fucking ass. But such is life. Yeah, but that's the city, right? But then I could think about her butt cheeks, that sale, that dinner over there. And I'm actually, I also think, fuck, man, someone else just got robbed right there. And can't people me think, hey, you overreact? You know, someone else that I know of did not react the way that I did, and they got robbed. And guess who else? Their mom got robbed. And they're lucky that their little sister didn't get killed. I don't even know if they reported to the cops, but for me, yeah, I'll be dead. We're fighting. Fucking someone's gonna get stabbed with a nose bitten off. And in the place recently where I went to go have dinner. And it's a busy area. Someone else got killed in a much nicer part of LA that I live in. I don't think anyone got caught. And it's funny that sometimes people don't want to say it was a black person that did it. I'm sorry from dating black women, I tell you that much. I like using the term being racist with people. I'll admit, I'll tell you what, I am racist. Don't tell no one, but really, I'm being honest here. Prefer to date big booty black women. I don't know why, just do. No, and I don't give a fuck if you have a master's, your own business, fucking chamber of commerce, and fucking whatever you like on Yelp. I don't give a shit about none of that. Grill a steak, suck a dick, and twerk it like a maniac. Goodness, you're a pervert. I didn't say that or think that. I don't doubt that in the future, everyone will just be canceled. Anything will be found in our past at all. Reinforce. Prove that you're a racist. I'm just amused by life that I'm still here, right in prison, alive, going forward. And Even though I woke up like that with the fucking trash can slung, I'm like, what? That's it. It's life. That's the universe saying, hey, get it done. Even one of them was like, yeah, it's the city here. We're surrounded by scumbags. Let's go. You see, that'd be the change you want to see in life. So think about what talked about this guy. Do that. That for now. We'll let that square these things away. Think about that. That's it for now, motherfuckers. Trump Rittenhouse 2024. And remember, when the going gets tough, let's go, Brandon.